Today's topic is going to be electricity. We all know that it's a very important part of life, and how much important we know now. Your chargers are, your mobiles are not charged. You cannot sit in front of me like this right now, okay? Virtually. So electricity has been a very important part of it. And in architecture, it plays a very important role in the sense that though it kind of looks very tiny, invisible, and I can do very well hiding it. And doing electricity in architecture is the least botherishing. I don't really have to make space provision and all that, unless you are designing a very large, complex structure where you will have to give generator rooms and transformer rooms and substations and all that. So we'll study what all that is. What all thing an architect study would be distribution of electricity and not how the generation happens and whatever. But tumhare building mein, how the electricity is distributed to various areas, that is all I think as an architect one has to be aware of. So let's do a little bit very generically, okay, right from the generation to the distribution of the building. So the generation, we know that obviously you have thermal power plants. We get our electricity from thermal power plants, right? So we have solar, okay, you have hydropower plant, you have tidal, you have nuclear, you have diesel, you have gas power plants, combined cycle plant, meaning they combine two or three cycles, okay? Wind, geothermal, biomass, fuel, there are many more, okay? And I'll show you a few examples where people are generating electricity from a very unusual kind of means, okay? And we'll look at that. I'll be showing you one case study. But these are some of the ways the generation happens as you have studied. Now, all the ones, if you see on the right-hand side, are all very, very sustainable. They're natural, okay? It's easily available. And it's free. All you need to do is just tap it. And secondly, it's clean. It does not give you any byproducts. So if I put photovoltaic cells on my building, there is no generation of ashes or heat produced or any kind of pollution is there. Only thing I need to take care of it is, how do I make my building in such a way that I can tap the solar energy to the max? That's where architectural forms can help you. So you have a flat terrace and you wish to have a solar. Maybe you did not think about applying solar at the start point of your building. But later on, you realize, you know, I really want to go for it. It can be done. So people have put up a kind of a table kind of thing on it, but that really spoils my roof. So what people nowadays do is they convert the entire terraces into urban farms and then protect it via the sun solar thing, kind of a pergola kind of a stuff. So design ka design and function ka function. So there are multiple ways it can be done. Ideally, if you think of it right from the beginning, you will orient and you will make a form of your building to take care of it. Tidal, we generally have it near the coast only, so there is a limitation. Wind also has a similar kind of a limitation in the sense I cannot do it in a city. I need to have an open place where I can be assured that winds are going to be there most of the time. Geothermal, again, is a, I need space. So if you have a complex, like say our building, we can have geothermal. Because we have lawns and I can dig my stuff inside it and run around. So we'll talk about what is geothermal when we come to it. And biomass is from what we do, the composting. So you have biogas, we have bioelectricity. So that can happen. Today, Curitiba and other places, Curitiba is a place in Brazil. Where? It is in Brazil or where? I forgot the place. Okay, Curitiba is the name of the city. Borneo? No. Should I forget the name? Bolivia? I absolutely forgot. Anyway, so Curitiba is one of the city which is really taking utilizing these kind of fuels for the buses. And Curitiba, by the way, is the first city which has BRTS in function. BRTS is bus rapid transit system, where you have the BRTS lane and the buses run to and fro without any hindrance of traffic or population, people crossing and stopping and all that. So they have undivided, complete lane all to themselves. So coming next is energy resource map of India, where it's basically trying to tell you where we can tap what energy, okay, and what, where is available. So obviously where there are massive rivers, you will have hydro. So if you see the top part of India, the northern part, where you do have very massive, because of the Himalayas and the snow-fed rivers, continuous rivers, perennial rivers, okay? So these are the rivers where you can have unlimited hydro potential. And many of our projects are happening today, okay? Bhakra Nangal Dam was the first one built there, and it's creating a huge electrical, this thing. So hydro potential is there in the north and the east part, where Brahmaputra plays a very important part, okay? Coal reserves are generally near Jharkhand area, West Bengal and Orissa part, okay? You have tidal in the complete south, but we have not really tapped tidal, not in India yet. Unfortunately, we are not really taking care of that. Distribution of energy resources and consumption centers are extremely unbalanced in most of the countries, and we will talk about it why. The reason is, initially, long time back, before the Britishers and all this, we used to have decentralized way of, pehle to electricity nahi tha in the first place, okay? People used to have very little electrical supply. But whatever the supply was decentralized. Yani you will have it at that place, and that place will only supply to particular area or neighborhood or city or whatever. With the centralized system, you talk about grid. And I'll show you one of the project, why that project was even thought about. Because of this sudden huge, so the grid fails. What happens when the grid fails? When the grid fails, the whole region, because the grid is not a small thing. So if I take a northern grid, the northern grid starts from your Chandigarh or Punjab, okay, right till your Bihar, okay? So that whole area will be in pitch darkness if the grid fails. And it has happened. I think it was in the year 1970s, yeah. 80s mein kabhi kuch hua tha, where the Delhi ka jo grid tha, something happened and the whole grid came to a standstill and complete power loss. Okay, so this can happen. Secondly, when you have a grid system, your power generation happens at one point and you have to carry it like kilometers away from the point of generation. And that means there is a loss of energy. So that's the problem. Okay, so just for you to understand this thing, I did a differentiate between water supply system and electricity so that you can understand. It's very difficult to, because as an architect, my knowledge about electricity is very limited, very frankly, okay, because I've never dealt with it. I have my electrical consultant who will probably tell me that I will need these kind of points and these kind of trunking and this kind of, you know, so when you have large servers, you will probably require some electrical calculations. So we have those people. But as an architect, what I do want to know is where those conduits will be, how many conduits will be there, how much space would be required, and probably they will give me some idea where I can then suggest that place, that this is a place where you can take them to. So let's understand how the systems work. And so if I talk about sources, my water sources are obviously lakes, rivers, ponds, wells. What are the sources for electricity? We just mentioned hydro, solar, wind, tidal, thermal, atomic. Water can be seen and felt. Okay. Electricity cannot be seen, but definitely felt. Anna? You touch it and probably that would be the last day you will be, if it is of a 420 volts. Okay. So, 440 volts. People have died of electrical shocks. Okay. Water is made of water molecules. Electricity is the flow of electrons. Okay. So, this is how the difference is. We can see water, we cannot see electricity, and that is the biggest problem. How is it carried from the source to the city? By huge pipes or conduits. We know that, right? We have seen it in the city, we have seen it in the pictures. Your Bandrawala slum. What is the name of the slum? which is on the east side. Okay, so that Bhairambada. So if you see that slum is resting on those huge water pipes, and many of the houses are built on those pipes. Those are your water lines. While how is electricity carried from, say, Dahanu to our place? High tension overhead cables of underground or underground armored cables. It should not be off, it should be or. Movement either by pumps or by gravity. Okay, how do you push water? Apne aap thoda aayega. So I need to pump the water. So wherever it is, wherever my water lines are coming from, okay, from some lake, and from there, if it has to come to Mumbai, there has to be huge pumping stations where it is going to pump or pull the water towards Mumbai. So that is way water travels. How does electricity travel? Similarly, I will apply pressure. What is electrical pressure known as? Voltage. So I will apply high potential difference, that is voltage, that is from high voltage to low voltage. Okay, so that's how the electricity will travel. Huge amount to be carried, okay? Use either larger capacity pumps or larger diameter of pipes. Okay, now if you see the yellow portion, and it's written there, what if there is a huge amount of water to be carried? Imagine water to be carried for the entire Mumbai city. In such a scenario, you saw the pipes diameter, okay? They are huge. I mean, a hut can stay on it, you know, it's that large. So if either I have a large diameter or I have massive pumps, obviously having larger diameter works well because they will be there and they are passive. But pumps are active. That means you have to give electricity and somebody has to pay for that electricity. And so obviously you will go for larger diameter. Not so in electricity. This is where the first difference comes in, okay? Use higher voltage or larger wire. Either way, I can use this. I can use larger wire or I can use larger pumps or voltage, right? Thicker cables capable of carrying currents. Barabara, na? If I have a thicker cable, more current will pass through. Why don't we do that? We'll see that. So this is how that overhead cables that you will see across the, when you travel by train or you travel by buses, you will see this happening in the city and outside the city where it is carrying these high tension cables all the way from the source of generation. Now, we don't use the thicker cables because thicker wire, when I have the thicker wire, there will be more resistance, okay? And the electricity is lost, okay? Hence, higher voltage is used to carry huge amount of electricity over long distances. So what we do is we don't ever have thicker cables which is passing across all the way, kilometers and kilometers. First of all, they are damn costly, okay? They are copper wires. So I will not have thick cables running from Dahanu to Mumbai. What I will do is, and that's the reason you have 11,000 kilovolts written there, right? So from there, it comes down to your 120 or 130 or whatever we are using, okay? 230 is what we use in India. So we come down to 230. But unlike water, where we have larger this thing, we don't have that in electricity, okay? For the simple reason is, loss of electricity. And loss of electricity is far more costlier than loss of water. I mean, either way, loss of water is also pretty bad because people are going without water in a city. Okay, so what is electricity? Understand electricity. It's a movement of electrons. Okay, so will electrons move on their own steam? No. Okay, you will need to give some kind of impetus. That is to say, some kind of charge you will have to get. That is your voltage. So what is this charge difference called? Potential difference or voltage? Electrons try to distribute themselves. I'm just refurbishing your knowledge about electricity, whatever you did in your 12th standard. Believe me, guys, this was not my favorite subject, okay? I was not too keen on electricity then, neither now. This is the subject always taken by Jimmy. I am sorely missing him. Electrons try to distribute themselves uniformly throughout the conductor, and in doing so, it flows from one terminal to another. As soon as I apply the potential difference, as soon as I apply the pressure, It's always higher potential to lower potential. Thus, the potential difference is the pressure that creates current in an electrical circuit. Now, because the source creates a potential difference, your source is the one where the electricity is created, could be thermal, hydro, whatever, okay? That forces current through a circuit. It is called electromotive force or electron moving force, EMF. Remember all these terms we did in our 12th standard? So current is what is nothing but the is a movement of free electron through a circuit, okay, under a applied EMF, that is your voltage. And so it travels from higher to lower potential. Okay. Volt is the unit of measurement of EMF or potential difference. We know that. Okay. Current. So what is current? It is necessary to study the rate of flow. Ab kitna electrons at a given point is going through a point is what my interest is. Based on which then I can do the calculation of whatever the amount of electricity reaching my whatever I need to take that electricity to. So how many electrons pass a given point in a circuit in 1 second? When a large number of electrons flow past a given point in 1 second, the rate of current flow is called ampere. So this is the definition of an ampere and this is the unit for current, okay? Ampere is not A, by the way, it is I. Okay, we denote current by the symbol I. When a large number of electrons pass through a point in 1 second is the current flow. Okay. Usually in our day-to-day life, current is measured in 5 ampere or 15 ampere. Yani ki you will have 5 ampere ka socket and 15 ampere ka socket. Now let's try this. What is the fridge? Socket, which kind of socket you will provide for refrigerator? So first of all, guys, do you know what is a 5 ampere socket and 15 ampere socket? Hello?
No.
You don't know? Okay. So if you see now, after we finish the lecture, please go towards your refrigerator and see that plug that is there in your socket. You understand what is a socket, right? Charger ke liye jo aap lagate ho, wo socket bolte hain usko. So, and plug is the one which is your charger ka jo tumhare haath mein hai, usko hum plug kehte hain. So you plug it into socket, aisa bola jata hai. So your 5 ampere is the... So basically, a socket is a appliance which allows you, or a fixture which not appliance, sorry, it's a fixture which allows you to charge your movable objects like your mobile, your toaster, your microwave, okay, which you buy from the market. So obviously, it will not have inbuilt electricity like your bulb and this thing. Na? So even bulb and tube you buy from outside. And then you put it there and the electricity will be there. So how do I then attach my refrigerator to the electricity? Through this plugging. Okay, so I plug it into a socket and electricity starts. So there are 5 ampere and 15 ampere. 5 ampere is for the smaller kind of appliances like your toaster, your mixer grinder, or your, for guys, it's that shaving thing, okay, whatever. But for larger appliances like your AC, okay, refrigerator, geyser, where extreme cooling and extreme heating is required, you have to have 15 ampere ka, this thing. So because I need larger current there. Okay. Can I change voltage in my normal day-to-day life? Can I change voltage in my normal day-to-day life? Hello? Nobody's daring. No, guys, I cannot. Where will I change it? Do I have the source? I can only do that at the source level. I do not have the source at my building, right? So I cannot change that. Simple. I can do that at the substation level, but not where I am having already a substation is providing me with one wire with, through which I'm doing the entire business of distribution. There is no way I can change voltage. The only way I can change is by giving these thicker wire and thinner wire, which will give me more. Of course, there is loss of electricity. You will say that. Yes. But kya kare? I need that. So yes, that is how it works. Free electrons pick up velocity in their movement along the conductor, converting potential into. So this is how the energy is transferred. Okay. So once you are standing and then you're made to move from potential to kinetic and you get the electricity. Electricity is and any energy, as I keep telling, Einstein said is energy cannot be created, cannot be destroyed. Before the electron has gone far, what happens? Ab metal hai, right? Metal mein jab aap electricity pass karte ho, so yes, it is made up of electrons. But the moment electrons are given some kind of charge, okay? So there is this magnetism, a magnetic theory, which electromagnetic, okay? And through which you are developing some ions within your conductor. And those are your restrictive force. Okay, so we talk about resistance before the end. That this is the reason why we don't have thicker wire. So please pay attention here. So before the electron has gone far, it collides with a relatively large metal ion. Okay, it relates with a large metal ion. So usse kya hota hai? Obviously, uska speed kam ho jata hai. So what is an ion? An ion is simply an atom or a group of atoms which by loss or gain of one or more free electron has acquired an electric charge. Now you have to understand this. Ek normal sa metal hai. It is at its normal level. Okay. Suddenly you apply some potential voltage and potential difference and the electrons aaye kahan se? Because your conductor is made up of atoms. Okay, and molecules. Now suddenly, where do you, and atoms, you know, is a stable thing. It has a nucleus and it has a ring of electrons around it. Now, why will atom come out of it? By some push, na? So by some force, you are extracting that electron out of that and you are making them flow. So that is how, but the moment I remove the electron, I am getting an ion because now that atom, which has lost an electron or a two, will acquire a positive charge. So those are my ions and these are my free electrons. So that's how I get an ion when the voltage is applied. Now, as a result of collision between free electrons and ions, the free electrons give up some of their kinetic energy to the ion in the form of heat energy. So that's the reason, guys, when the electricity passes through a conductor or aapne agar usko haath lagaya, to it turns a little hot. This is that heat energy being converted because the ions are resisting the flow of electrons. And that is why a conductor feels warm to touch when a current is passing. If the amount of heat produced in the conductor is more than it can dissipate, the temperature of that conductor will rise to create a fire hazard. This is where we start having problems. So the idea is you should have minimum resistance in this, okay? That is the reason why after a certain period of time, maybe 10 years, 15 years, people go for changing their electrical circuit because of this reason. Metal purana ho gaya hai, there is some gaps in it, something has cut in due to heat, okay? And so there are these kind of issues happening inside and that's the reason why we need to refurbish our electrical wiring. Or it can lead to these kind of issues where more heat is generated, which kind of burns the insulation on top of it. You know what is an insulation, right? Wo plastic covering jo wire ke upar hota hai. So that it gets burned and your wire, your live wire is exposed. And by chance, if another live wire comes in contact with this live wire, you have a short circuit. And short circuit, what happens is it creates a huge energy. It creates sparks and more insulation is burned and probably the fire hazard is there. Now, so, since current is the movement of free electrons, the collisions of the current, okay, obviously will oppose the current. Resistance is that property of an electrical circuit that or which opposes current. And the unit of resistance is ohms. We had Ohm's law, remember? So what is the relation between, now you don't need to know this, but as a theory, you guys are lucky, you don't have to give this paper in university. A few years back, people had to actually give board exams, university exams, where they had to give this. And this was one of the questions asked always. Okay. So as a theory, I'm taking it. But frankly, as an architect, I am really not bothered about this. But there is no harm in gaining knowledge. Okay. So voltage is the current in amperes into impedance. Okay. So basic, but what I remember studying when I was in college was this. I is equal to V upon R. This was the formula which I remembered always. So I is equal to V upon R. I will tell you why I remember this formula more is because of this reason. So now remember, go back to the slide where I said thicker. Yeah, it's nostalgic. Thicker wire क्यों नहीं होता है अभी आपको दिखेगा क्यों नहीं मोर द वोल्टेज नाउ सी सामने यू लुक एट द फॉर्मूला करंट इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू वोल्टेज यानी इफ आई इंक्रीज माई वोल्टेज टू 11,000 केवी वॉट विल बी माई अमाउंट ऑफ करंट रनिंग इट विल बी लाइक फास्ट गाइस इट विल बी लाइक द स्पीड ऑफ लाइट ओके आई मीन ऑफकोर्स नॉट बट आई एम जस्ट सेइंग इट विल बी दैट फास्ट ओके मोर द वोल्टेज हायर इज द करंट More the voltage, what will happen? Resistance will be lesser, right? Because it is indirectly proportional. Agar mera current zyada hai, to mera resistance kam hoga. Okay? And obviously, if current is more, voltage is more. And that's the reason, if I have to travel my electricity from Dahanu to Mumbai, Colaba, okay, which is like a long distance, I will not have thicker wires. More, I am giving more ion formation possibility. I will try to see that I have thinner wire, but I make higher potential, so I get larger current. This is the reason why we don't have thicker wires. Because thicker wire, thicker resistance. These are some of the formulas, okay? The red ones are the one I'm interested in from an architect point of view because I'm talking about green buildings, I'm talking about sustainability. Okay, I'm actually calculating, not me, but there is no harm in knowing it because when you are talking to your client and if you rapidly say this kind of formula, believe me, guys, it really creates an impact. Not necessarily to all clients, but this only happens when you have the your design is finished, you have discussed with your clients, you have discussed with everything, and you have a yes nodding, and you have already begun with your, and then when you have to convince your client that if you apply this kind of fixture, you will have this kind of savings. Tab jaake ye sab kaam mein aata hai, okay? Where you can actually show them via calculation that you can save. And I am, believe me guys, clients are least interested in energy. But when you convert that energy into money, you see kaisa nod milta hai aapko. Okay, so energy consumption is calculated is kilowatt per hour. When you see your electric bill gives you this. So please go now after this lecture is over. You have two jobs to do. One is check out your 5 ampere socket and 15 ampere socket. And second thing is take a bill, ask your father and mother, where are the electrical bills kept? And go through this. So your units that you consume per month is given in kilowatt per hour. So the formula is wattage, that is kilowatt into hours of operation, either per year, per day, per month is your choice. Okay. But if I'm doing a calculation for a client and I really want to impress him, I would be doing it per year because mujhe salana kitna bachta hai, ya fir I'll do it for a month. Because that will give an idea that how much bills you are paying per month. Per day, I'm really not interested in. So either I calculate for a month or I calculate it for the entire year. Hours or operation per year is equal to operating hours per day. Yani suppose I'm calculating the wattage of computer. So you say, okay, I'm working 8 hours per day. Every day, I work 8 hours per day on my computer and then it's a me time for me. So I will calculate wattage of the computer if I'm only calculating this as only 8 hours. So when we do the calculation for our college, we generally take from morning 8 to 5. Beyond that, generally college shuts only when there is the end time, like September, October, when the first semester is getting over, when people stay back. And when you have March and April, when people stay back. So beyond these 2 months, most of the time, college shuts by 5. So operating hours per day, that is 8 hours, into operating days per week, aap kitne din mein kaam karte ho? So you say, okay, our colleges were functioning 6 days. So you multiply by 6, so 8 into 6, into operating weeks per year. So minusing your Diwali holidays, your May vacation, your Christmas vacation, okay, and all the chuttis, and we say, okay, 15 days, so half a month. So you calculate weeks, okay, of actual functioning college. And that's how you get the hours of operation. That's why making it for a year, this is how it helps. So hours of operation, the formula is given below. It's basically a very simple formula. So for example, 6 hours per day into 5 days into 24 weeks. This is how you have to calculate for a year. Lighting system efficiency or efficacy, sorry, is lumens per watt or LPW. Is equal to system lumen output divided by input wattage. Ye aapko nahi calculate karna hai. This is given. Okay. This is mostly there on your fixtures and all this. That's why the focus on the red one. These are your important ones. These ones are just general terms that if you come across, you should know. Unit power density, again, I'm not really interested in. You can say that when I do a high-rise building and when I do a small institutional building, then probably as a comparison, this can help. Yani ki aapka total wattage per area obviously will be too high in a complex high-rise building. When I do a chotu institution like ours, this density will be so less because we don't work throughout the day. We have only 8 hours we work, okay? Usme bhi half the time studios are not there, lectures are happening, so all the lights will be off. Hopefully, all the fans will be off, but ACs will be working, and ACs are not going to be on throughout the day. So it will be very like mini kind of density compared to the high rise. So this is generally used for getting an idea of how much you are spending as an energy. So higher the density, you know you are in a problem, or you then go for a sustainable systems. Watts are nothing but volts into current amperes into power factor. Voltage, we studied there, okay, I is equal to V upon R. So V will be IR, current into resistance. Foot candles was the initial, before, I think, Britishers ke time pe, they used to calculate the light in terms of foot candles, okay. So it's basically total lumens, and we will study what is lumens, okay, LM, divided by area. Lumens and lux we will do when we do the lighting. Okay, so when you do the lighting, so what is lighting? How is I'm making my work surface visible or making it easier for my eye? So that is the lux I require. Okay, so when I say lux, you need to know that if I am having a studio, what will be your lux requirement? Or if I'm having a computer and I'm working on it, what would be the lux requirement? Obviously, for the studio, it is higher because my computer is self-lighted. So even if there is a little low lux, I can manage my keyboards, okay? So this kind of knowledge you will get when we do the lighting. Right now, just focus on lumen. Understand these two words, lumen and lux, okay? So we will do this again when we do the lighting. So don't worry, I will take this up when we go back there. Now coming, this is the important part where an architect really needs to know, because aapko hi dena hai cutouts in the slab, where your conduits are going, how your false ceiling is planned so that all the points are given on the false ceiling, how it is hidden, what kind of systems you will be adopting. So this is where you really need to understand. So generators produce electricity. Then we have, I talked about grid. Okay, this consists of many wires carried across country on large pylons. Pylons is the picture I showed you of those towers where you carry the the conduits carrying from Dahanu to Mumbai kind of thing, which link the generating station to the supply area, okay, and distribute electricity. The demand for electricity is estimated at a regional control center where it is decided which generators will be run and which will be brought in use as the demand increase. This is where your substations are coming, okay? By means of the national grid system, a sudden excessive demand in one area can be met, if necessary, by generators many miles away in another part of the country. Say, for example, Mumbai has suddenly, so there is a disaster, and I require these kind of, because some lines have fallen down, they are not functioning, the need for the electricity increases. These kind of setup will help in a grid system, which will not be there in a decentralized system, okay? Decentralized will help you throughout the year, but a grid system will definitely help you when you have major disasters striking you. Okay, the generation of power is at 3.3 kilovolts and 11 kilovolts. Okay, when I say 11 kilovolts means 11,000 volts. Kilo is 1 kilovolt is equal to 1,000 volts. So when you say 1,000 volts, yani ke 11 kV. So 11 might seem very small to you, but look at the terms, the units, kV. The voltage is then, okay, stepped up to 220 kV. Now, can you beat that? You're talking about 11 kV, 11,000 volts. That is also 440 volts. You put a skull and a bone below, cross bone, to show that this is dangerous for your life. Can you imagine 11 kV? And then can you imagine 220 kV? That means what? 220 and three zeros, okay? It's like amazing kind of voltage you are creating. Or 440 kV for long distance transmission. And after reaching the substation, it is stepped down. So you must have heard this somewhere in your life up till now. Step up transformers, step down transformers, okay? Now, when we have a large kind of electricity being brought to the city, is there a way? It's like water supply, okay? Aapka, remember the ferrule? Okay, remember the connectors, connection pipes and the service pipes and all those, same thing. So imagine I have this huge diameter of pipe which is having tremendous pressure. Now if I have my teeny weeny half inch ka pipe which is supplying to my building, how the hell am I going to see that my pipes won't burst because pressure manage nahi kar pa raha hai. That's the reason why I will have ferrule, well, I'll have that brake pressure and all that kind of gadgets are done there, which will help find a gooseneck will be there, which will then help me to the point where my water is handled by my half inch, 3/4 inch ka pipe. Similarly, imagine 11,000 kilovolts to convert that. 11 kV is the production hota hai. When I have to carry it, what they do is at the generator, they have something called as transformers. These are the machines which have the capacity to increase. Jaise humare paas pumps hote hain, wahan pe transformers hote hain. So the transformer will pump up, will increase the voltage, okay, to 220 or 440 kVs. And that is then brought to the cities or wherever they are away from. Okay? Now you have this huge, tremendous pressure at the gate of the city and city don't know what to do. So then the city will have various substations. Okay, the substations are at a neighborhood levels. So you will have one main substation where major kind of transformers will be stepping it down. Uska pressure kam karenge, okay? And this reduced pressure is then distributed to other substations within the city where again it is reduced down. And then you will finally get at Juhu, at Kandivali, at Borivali, and wherever you guys are staying. But everywhere there are these substations where it will be reduced. Because as in water supply, everywhere there will be ferrule. Similarly, everywhere there will be substations. But the difference is one substation can fairly manage a large neighborhood. Unlike a water. Water does not have that kind of network. So because it's pumped, okay, physical, it's like manually taking the water because it's physical. While electrons are very tiny and not visible to eye. So it's easier and faster to travel. but not water. Water is heavier. I need larger pumps physically. And that's why there is no network for water, kind that kind of stuff, but you have for electricity. And so these are the these places are called as substations. Up till now, clear? Do you have any questions? Hello, guys. Hai ki gaye?
Yeah.
Very good. Parth, any questions?
No. Nothing.
No.
Is it clear up till now?
Yeah.
Okay. So this was the distribution of electricity at a mota moti level, at the city level. Okay. More important would be what happens when it comes to your area, I mean your building which you are designing. Okay. So just look at this diagram. So you have national from, or you have evolution of grid interconnection in India. Okay. So we used to have local chotusa kind of a generator. And we'll have a neighborhood level of supply. Then it became state. Then it became regional. And now it is national. So today we have this kind of a grid. So we have national grid, which is supplying huge areas. And I mean huge meaning, imagine you are getting your electricity from Dahanu. Thermal plant in Dahanu, okay, by Reliance is providing you the electricity at Bombay. What is the distance? आप ट्रेन में जाते हो तो 3 घंटा 3.5 घंटा लगता है. तो फॉर दैट मच डिस्टेंस यू हैव टू ट्रैवल दोज थिंग एंड कम. सिमिलरली इक्वली ऑन द अदर साइड ऑफ दानू इट इज सप्लाइंग. तो इट टेक्स अ ह्यूज रेडियस एंड सप्लाइज टू द एंटायर काइंड ऑफ रीजन. ओके, दैट्स योर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. To avoid losing energy in transmission, voltage is stepped up, as I clearly told you, because I is directly proportional to V. If I have larger voltage, I will have larger volume, current, but very, very small resistance. And that is what I want, because the more resistance, more heat will be created and more energy will be lost, which I don't want. So I have, if I have long distance, I will carry the, I will carry it with a higher voltage. That's why even in substation, aapne agar raste pe, agar next time you walk, I don't know when will be that next time, please don't go out of the house because I'm telling you, okay, to observe. But agar aapne kabhi pichle samay mein kabhi dekha hoga to, you will see these red boxes. Now there are two kinds of red boxes you will see on the road. One is for the telephone guys and the other one is for the electricity. Unfortunately, they have chosen both as a red color. So it's very difficult, but it is easier if you see the symbol on it. So where it is electrical kind of that dabba, okay, it is known as, I mean, that symbol of crossbones with a skull is given on it to show that this is dangerous. While your telephone wala does not have such kind of symbols. So people will come and operate. And this used to happen when we had MTNL. Now with the mobile, that dabba is now an obsolete kind of a thing. MTNL, by the way, is shutting down. Almost, I mean. So this is those tiny substations that we talk about, okay? So even there, the voltage is pretty high. It's 440 volts. So either high tension overhead cables or underground cables, say, aap Dahanu se Mumbai laaye hain, theek hai? It then comes to the transformer station where it is again stepped down. From there, it is led to substation where it is distributed at area level. Okay. The reason it is stepped up so hugely is because I already said that. Okay. So voltage increases, current increases. Resistance decreases, current increases. So that's how the reason why I have this. So how it is stepped up and stepped down by a transformer, okay, by transformers. So just as in water, you had pumps, in electricity, we have transformers. This is how it happens, okay. Really, look at the kind of figures they have. It's like 400 kilovolts, 765 kilovolts. But generally in India, we have it at 11,000 kilovolts, 220 and 440. 11 ka table yaad rakho. These are how my transformers and substation look at a city level, okay? It will not happen at a building level. building will have a substation. It will be of a smaller kind. Now, why will a building need a substation? You may very well ask that question. Is because when I have a high-rise building, Burj Khalifa, imagine Burj Khalifa will be having, oh my Lord, tremendous. It has 100 kilometers of water lines. Just water line, uska 100 kilometers hai. Think about the electrical lines, because electrical lines will be going to each and every gadget. Tumhara water lines toilet tak jayega and that's it. But electrical will go everywhere. It's like, I don't know, massive kilometers of electricity, sirf lines hai. What about the consumption? So imagine not having a substation there is a problem. I need a high voltage coming in where I need to probably step up a little bit. Okay, or the stepped up voltage will come in where I need to step down and supply it. So this I will, that's the reason why we have substation in a complex kind of building, or we say advanced building. So at area level, you have these feeder pillars. Okay, so those red color cup pillars I just talked about with those crossbone and the skull is nothing but a feeder pillar. So you have a substation, say, let's talk about Juhu since we are all associated with that. So at Juhu, you will have one substation. From substation, it will go to these various feeder pillars. Aapne ek jagah pe nahi, kai jagah pe you will see that these are these kind of red pillars or boxes, not pillars, post kind of a thing with a box on it. And if you open it, you will see the lights blinking in there and some tubes are, and you will see massive conduits being laid out. Okay, niche se black color ka. So that will then go underground, and from underground, one conduit can supply at least 10 to 15 buildings. Okay, so that's how the entire distribution is done at the city level. So at area level, I will have something called as FP, or feeder pillars are needed from where it is again distributed. Now, guys, agar aapko bhook lagi hai, please go to your kitchen and get something to eat, because this is where you need to concentrate now. Okay, abhi tak to theek tha, because nobody is ever going to call you for city level electricity. Okay, this is not our job, but for an electrical distribution for a building, you will be required as an architect. Now, what happens at the distribution at building level? Okay, aur kya kya aapko jagah provide karni hai. So now imagine you have a feeder pillar. Feeder pillar ke niche se you will see this various kind of thick conduits. Thick yane, aap apne pura haath usko aise pakad sakte ho. That kind of a thick conduit is going by. And there would be around 5 to 6 of them. And each of them, as I said, can feed about 15 to 20 buildings, or maybe more. I don't know. Okay. But so they will go underground, and it will be laid either on the side of the road or the center of the road as per the planning. And from there, a wire will be taken inside building number one, another wire to building two, another wire to building three. Similarly, it will supply to God knows how many. Let's be interested in our building. Okay, so once the wire comes in, water mein kya tha? Ferrule ke baad, what was the thing which will keep a control by the BMC on you? You used to have a stopcock, which was only handled by the BMC. Similarly, agar aapne electric bill nahi bhara, you are not paying the electric bill, then you have this cutout. So this is what you had, a kind of a stopcock in your water supply. You have a cutout in electricity. I am trying to make this an analogical drawing. Study, so that it's easier. Water supply is easier than electricity. Okay, because we see that within a building, comma, electricity passes through a cutout, which is a fuse kind of a thing. Okay, in case of bills are not paid, cutout is simply pulled out. Jaise stopcock ko band karte hain and your building is bereft of water. Similarly, you take out the entire cutout and the whole building will be in the darkness till you pay the bill. Now the next step is called the bus bar. So your tumhara electrical line andar aaya, andar aake you have this kind of a cutout switch. Okay, we call it a switch. It passes through that. Okay, and you have a cutout. The wire will go further, and further jaake kahan jayega? It will go to the bus bar chamber. or we call it as a meter room. So in electricity, you will have a meter. Now, when I'm talking about meter, this is all about talking about money. And when it comes about money, it comes about who is going to pay. This is where distribution takes care, and you need to question this. Whenever you design, you need to design your electric room based on who is going to pay the bill. Okay, and I'll give you three examples and we'll discuss this. Okay, and then probably we take a break or we take it next time onward, because ye important hai aapko samajhna. Say for our institute, Kamla Raheja, who pays the bill? Kamla Raheja, barabar? Do you and me pay? Or faculty room, faculty bharta hai, library wala Manju pays, or somebody else pays? No, na? One bill goes from KRVIA as a complete. Okay. So that is called institutional level or a commercial bills, where it will be only 1 meter. Itni badi dukaan lagi hui hai, itna bada institute hai, but I require only 1 meter. Because one person is paying the bill. Coming to your individual buildings, theek hai? Aap apne individual buildings ki baat karo. So imagine you are having 30 flats, 40 flats, I don't know how, or you are staying in a bungalow, or you are staying in a row house. Chalo, we take all these cases. If you are staying in a row house, and if that row house has a kind of a community thing, do you think there will be separate metering? Of course. Okay, I might use electricity for a long time. You might be traveling, so you won't have any electric bill for that month. Why should you share my electricity bill if it is a combined bill? No way. Every house, whether it's a row house, whether it's an apartment, whether it's a bungalow, if you are using it, you will pay for it. Okay, so all residentials are given separate metering. Now, if you, so obviously, if I have a small 25 floor ka building hai, 4 flats per floor, and I have niche stilt. And if 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is my level, and I have 20 flats, there will be only 20 meters plus 1 for the society. Because who will pay for the pumps, the lift, your staircase ka lights, your compound lights, your terrace lights, and whatever extra there is there, okay? So obviously, society will pay for it. So that's why you pay maintenance. So you will basically have 21 meters in your society if your building is, so you will size your room according to that 20 meters. Now, who will do this? Obviously, an architect, na? Because he's planning. He knows the number of flats and he knows the number of meters that will come. So it is your job to give me that space as a meter. And when I plan my meter room, you have to be double cautious. Okay, initially, if anybody of you, okay, agar aap koi purane building mein rehte ho, like really old, okay, which is yet not gone for redevelopment. And by just chance, if you happen to walk, I will tell you where to go. If you want to go, you go to BDD Chawl, or you go to any of these chawls in Parel, they still have this kind of system. So you have a staircase which takes you up. You will have a small plinth, 0.45 ka. You climb those 3 steps and then you... it takes you up. Now, under that staircase, you will have a very triangular kind of a wall. Wahan pe tumhare meters lagate. Kyunki those flats, those BDD chawls had G+3. Okay. And they had merely some 15 to 20 tenants. So they would have those 20 meter boxes fit there. But they were exposed to all kind of mischief. There was another problem. Exposed to flooding in Mumbai. Major problem. Imagine electricity and water, terrible condition, okay, terrible situation. This is where you as an architect will enter the picture. So whenever you plan your electric room should be like a fort. Usme kuch nahi jana chahiye, na kuch aana chahiye, sivai hawa. Because I need to ventilate that, because I told you, if the resistance, by chance, if there is heat produced for whatever reason, and electricity and heat goes hand in glove. So if by chance, if that happens and you don't cool your room, you are in for a major, major problem and it can be an inferno, okay? What you can do is, yes?
Why don't we have the meter room on the terrace?
Okay, why don't we have the meter room on the terrace? First of all, very good question. Excellent question and good you asked me. So kya hota hai? What is easier to carry and what is sasta to carry? Okay, answer my question. Is it easy for me to carry 2 inch ka water pipe up or a 1/2 inch ka water pipe up? Answer me.
1/2 inch.
1/2 inch, right? Same thing with electricity. So if I am supplying my electricity to the entire 28 flats or 30 flats, chalo, I'll take 30 as a figure, okay? 30 flats ko mujhe electricity dena hai. Before I distribute to 30, there will be one bulk wire that will be containing all that 30 electricity combined units, right? That will be heavier. So I will have to travel that distance more, okay, all the way to the terrace and then bring it down. That is the first problem. The second one is water bill. Generally, aate hain log, and that's why where do we used to put the water bills? Near the compound wall. Electric ke liye bhi log aate hain, bachcha. So obviously, if you have, and terraces are generally kept locked because today we almost all of us are staying in 7-floor, 8-floor buildings, and terraces can become a hazard, okay? Especially when kids go up and nobody is there to monitor them. So generally, terraces are kept locked. So if this guy comes to monitor your meter and charge you the bills, you will be have to, I mean, somebody has to be there, open the terrace. Agar chabi gum gaya hai ya kisi ke paas hai, you know, terraces people sometimes borrow. These are the practical problems that occur. And that's the reason why an electric room has to be at the ground floor and can be easily accessed by the people who come from outside to look at your meters and charge you. So every time at the month end, you will have an electric person coming and they actually write down your metering this thing. So this is how it is taken care of. Okay? Is that clear why it is not at the meter, at the terrace room?
Yeah, got it.
Yeah. And also one thing, after this corona business is over and hopefully it will be done fine, okay, by soon. But if when we get time, look into your building, baju wale building mein jao, teesre building mein jao, go somewhere else. Nowhere you will see that the meter room is kept on the top because of this reason. Water meter ko hum compound wall ke paas isiliye rakhte hain taki pehle to water ki chori na ho, and secondly, it is very easily accessible. Similarly, for the electrical also, metering has to be at a place where I can easily access if I am the metering guy. Theek hai? Is that clear?
Theek hai? But so now, when it floods...
So when it floods, so when you plan, tumhara jo plinth level hota hai, which is generally 0.6 or 0.45, whatever you have planned, but it will be different for the electric level. Electric ko up or extra, because it can be outside your building. I mean, it will be a part of your building, but it will be at the ground floor. So height, agar mujhe thoda kam mile, toh that's fine. Because a meter is nothing but a small box, which I put it on a wall and which digitally shows me the number of units I have used in my house for a month. So it's a small digital box. So even if I put it up, that's fine. So even if my room height is 2.4, I am quite happy. So if my plinth is say 5 feet, okay, 0.75, 5 feet zyada ho jayega, 0.75, okay, that would be good, okay, or 0.6, 0.75. People have kept as high as 0.9. So that is the planning that goes into it, okay? Fine. So once then, so I talked about the meter. Okay, now what happens now in the new redevelopment that has happened, and I'm still at the meter room, I'm bus bar mein ja nahi rahi. So at the meter room, so we discuss one institution and one purely residential. Many of us, my building has this. I don't know about your building, but think about it. You will also have certain shops below and you will have your houses above. Now, who pays for those shops? Will there be another meter or they will have a combined 1 meter? What do you think?
Another meter.
Hello. They will have another meter. Will it be 1 meter or will be jitna shop hai utna meter?
Jitna shop hai utna.
Very good. So obviously, guys, same principle works there. Unless it has been, the whole area has been planned as if a larger kind of franchisee can be given out. Like many buildings will have a large area below. So generally, a McDonald's will take it, okay? Or any big franchisee kind of a stuff, supermarket kind of stuff, which do require a large area, they will take it. So the planning then goes like that. I don't want that janjat of 7 shops. Each one of them will have different issues. And I don't want that. So as a planner, as an architect, you have planned it, or whoever is your client, the builder or whoever it is, has approached you with this idea in mind. Okay, I am designing this at the edge of a Pavai, this thing. And it's on the main road. Chalo. So I want that area to be little larger so that a big franchisee can come there. I don't want small shops there. So you will plan accordingly, and then accordingly plan your meter room, because your jitne bhi shops hai, usme se ek hi then, only one guy, because one franchisee is there. So that is also another level of planning. So guys, what I'm trying to say here is, and I will always say this, as an architect, we visualize, right? We create spaces. Before you create spaces, na, you please create scenarios. Ki tum space kiske liye create kar rahe ho? And what can happen in that space? Can I divide the space in future? What will happen if this happens? What will happen if that happens? That is planning, na? City planning yahi to hai. Because city planning is so vast and so large. If I don't create scenarios, I'm doomed. Okay, my city is doomed. And that's what smart cities is talking about. Smart cities is providing you with solutions, which is kind of automatic. So all these systems of waste management and district cooling and district heating, which is all automatic. Even if human errors are there, machines are taking care of you. Okay. So that's smart city. Not a very wise idea, because that means we are eliminating the responsibility part of the humans. Hum zyada se zyada then irresponsible hote jate hain. So I think it's more important to build an attitude of sustainability rather than depending on your machines. Maybe I'm old-fashioned, but I believe very strongly in that. Machines can anytime go blank out and then you are lost. So coming to meter room back again. Once I have, so you have planned your meter room based on the number of meters that is going to be there. Okay, so we created these certain scenarios. Single meter, multiple meter, residential and commercial meters. Okay, you have industrial meters. Suppose you have 3 sections in your Burj Khalifa. Take Burj Khalifa, okay? It has residential, it has offices, and it has restaurants. Suppose by chance it had some manufacturing unit as well, which will be kind of a mini industrial zone. Then that metering will be different, because charges for electricity, for commercial, for industrial, and for residential are varying. So industrial pay a very huge amount of electricity compared to what I pay for one unit. Okay, I might pay some 20 bucks while he pay 200 bucks. That can be the varying. I don't know exactly how much industrial pay, but that's roughly the difference. So once now the meter room is standing, in the meter room, my cutout will happen. Obviously, usko main kahin bahar to nahi rakh sakti, because it's electricity. I cannot expose this to water. So I will allow that pipe, that is pipe in the sense that conduit of wire, which is carrying the, which is having the capacity to distribute to my 30 flats. Okay. It's coming all the way inside my meter room. First, it is passing through this cutout switch, where it gives me the gives the guy the possibility to take out the switch and push the building into darkness. Then this wire passes ahead and goes into something called as bus bar. Water ka distribution kaise hota tha? Okay, you used to store water at UG level. Theek hai? Pani aaya bada pipe mein. Okay, 2 inch ka pipe mein, you are getting the water line inside. Okay, after it passes through water meter, it comes all the way and drops into your UG. Phir UG mein aap pump lagate the. You will take the water all the way to OHT and then forget about it, because gravity will work and you don't have to spend any kind of money. That was how. Ek second, guys. Ready? Haath do ya? Haath do ya? Pehla haath do. पच्ची कपड़ा बदलो तुमने कई कई ने उठा की प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड यार. Okay, sorry. Where was I? This is what happened. Where was I? Bus bar, right. I was at the bus bar. Okay, so once it comes in, okay, only 5 minutes more, guys, then we take a break because this is too long. So the bus bar is nothing. So I was telling you about the Wataka thing. So once it goes to the OHT and it distributes by pipes into your individual houses. Barabar hai. But it doesn't happen like that in electricity. Electricity mein aap imagine karo, okay? You have this one thick conduit that is coming in, which is electrical and which is having too much of power. You can't touch it, okay? Pani ko to aap touch kar sakte ho, but you can't touch that electricity. And you have to see that one wire is now supplying to 30 different flats. So aap kaise karoge? You somewhere need a machine or a appliance which will do this separation. That is your bus bar. Okay? So I am not going into bus bar today. We will continue next time because it's already 12:30. We started at 11:15. And I know electricity can be a little dry and a little dead topic. But when I show you the examples, you will love it. I'm sure you will like it. Okay? So are we okay? Can we, do you have any questions? Yes, thank you, Anushki. Kurtiba is in Brazil. So I was right, my initial thing. Okay, I'm stopping the recording. Any questions, guys?